Hey, everybody. I am Josh Jordan. Welcome in. I'm the editor of Sports Map, host of Moneyline on ESPN Sundays. And I am joined by AJ Hoffman, host of The Blitz, weekdays on ESPN 97.5 and 92.5. AJ, our own John Granato, made news this week on his show when he shared that his sources close to the Texans are saying that Josh McCown is the Texans' next head coach in waiting.
Josh McCown will be your head coach at some point in the next 3 years or so. That's a real thing. That's not a, oh, we're guessing. That's a real thing.
I just got your information verified, by the way. That is all true.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, AJ. How well can current Texans head coach David Culley really groom Josh McCown when he's never been a coordinator, much less a coach himself?
It's a good question. I mean, you're going to be leaning a lot on the staff around you. I mean, I think Lovie Smith being in the building will help, a guy who's had some experience as a head coach, both in the NFL and at the college level. I think that they are looking at this guy as sort of a guy who's going to learn everything. Like, it's almost like an intern program where I think he's going to be passed around and he's going to learn how to do a little bit of this and a little bit of that. And they're hopeful that by the end of this thing, he's a well-rounded head coaching candidate. I know they like him a lot. I mean, it's hard. It is difficult to say what he's capable of because we've never seen even a glimpse of it other than on the field. But it's definitely something new and innovative, a new and different way to try to find a head coach.
This coach in waiting stuff, it doesn't always work out that great, right? I tried to think of some examples, you know, like Josh McDaniels, you know, when he backed out of the Colts job, we heard that there were promises made that he would be the head coach in waiting with the Patriots. And now we're hearing that's not really true. I can think of Will Muschamp. He was the coach in waiting with the Longhorns, and then he left and went to Florida. I mean, can you really think any situations where something like that has actually played out and worked?
I mean, I think there's some situations in like maybe college basketball or things where there's been a guy groomed to be the next guy in line. But in football, it is a rare thing. And Will Muschamp, when I worked in Austin when that happened, and when they named Will Muschamp the head coach in waiting, he wasn't even really approaching the idea of leaving anytime soon. So it was really sort of, there was no time limit on it. And when you're a guy like Will Muschamp, who at the time was a very, very hot commodity, it's one thing to say you're going to be the next guy here. But then if someone with a job like Florida, which is a lot in a lot of people's minds, at least an equal head coaching job to Texas, and that gets offered to you, well, I'm no longer the head coach in waiting. This is a right now thing. So it is sort of an open-ended thing, the head coach in waiting, because and obviously they don't want to make it seem like David Culley's only going to be here a year and be gone. So it's just an odd situation. It's something that doesn't happen often, because often if you're that good of a coach, somebody will just offer you a job before the team that you're waiting with is able to.
Now, that's a good point. I mean, if McCown is the heir apparent to the head coaching job, is it likely that, you know, maybe he'll move into a coordinator position first, or will the team elevate him straight to head coach like Culley? In other words, will the Texans hire two head coaches back to back with no coordinator experience?
Well, I mean, it's entirely possible. I wouldn't put it out of the realm with this team. Who knows? I mean, what the way this team, the direction that they're headed now, I think saying like, would they do this is so out the window, because how many of the things that they've done in the last, you know, 2 years, would you say, would they do this? Of course not. Would they trade David Johnson for nothing? Of course not. Would they, you know, fire Bill O'Brien in the middle of a season after they gave him all the power in the world? Of course not. And they do. I mean, they just continue to break any expectations that we could have. Would they really pick Jack Easterby over Deshaun Watson? Of course not. Well, so would they be willing to make a guy who's been a quarterback's coach or something like that take him straight to a head coaching job if that's the guy they like? Of course not.
Okay, final question. Going with that theme, you know, if they like McCown so much, you know, and they've already taken so much heat for other stuff, why not just give him the gig right away and you know, do without the in waiting? Why didn't they just hire him?
I think because they understand, they believe, and that's why they didn't go out and make a big money hire with David Culley. They understand that right now this isn't a winnable situation. And if you make this Josh McDaniels' first job, or Josh McDaniel, if you make this Josh McCown's first job, and he's destined to fail, that can ruin a coach forever. So that's why I think a lot of coaches were hesitant to take this job, because they know this isn't a job that's going to be an easy one to succeed in. I think that they want to let the talent level develop here a little bit, to where they feel like they can be a competitive team before they throw that guy full on into the fire.